A solid start, Aidan. Let's try and push it further.
Copy that. Where's Casper?
He's up ahead. Let's try and bring you two closer together. Casper's in P10 at the moment.
Great manoeuvre. You made it look easy.
Casper is a couple of places up on you. You're closing in on Casper now, Aidan. Good job. Casper is directly ahead of you.
Okay, you're creating some breathing space between you and the car behind by a few seconds per lap.
And these two have been fighting each other incredibly hard so far. They don't want to go tripping over each other, though, because Devon Butler is coming up from behind. He's on the attack, too.
Aidan, Casper's not your priority. We need you to defend.
It's okay. I've got this.
Here comes Butler. Three abreast going into turn 11. Oh, this can't work! And it doesn't! Ackerman's off onto the verge of what looks like damage as well.
Is he okay? Is Casper okay?
He'll be fine. He's heading for the pits now. You just concentrate on the race.
There we have it. Well, I'm sure there's going to be fireworks at the Alfa Romeo garage tonight.
There will be, Crofty, for sure. Look, it was a late move from Devon Butler, but you never want to see two teammates make contact, and Ackerman will surely be seething at that one.
Absolutely. And I tell you who else isn't going to be happy too. Aidan Jackson. Not how his F1 race debut should have gone.
The damage appears to be minor. How's it feeling, Aidan?
Yeah, car's okay.
Understood. See how well you can do out there.
Copy.
The gap to the car behind is 6.7 seconds. Nice move. Good job. Okay, you're in the top 10. That's P9, ninth place now. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Green flag. You're putting a good distance between yourself and the car behind. Okay, good work. Great pass. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. The gap to the car ahead is 4.4 seconds. This is your final lap of the race. That's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
Another superb Australian Grand Prix comes to an end, and it's a thoroughly deserved victory. What a start to the season this has been. A fascinating race here in Australia, Ant.
The top teams as ever continue to push the boundaries of the sport, and it'll be interesting to see how the new Alfa Romeo driver Aidan Jackson settles in, especially after that early incident involving his teammate.
Well, we've certainly seen rivalries born from less. Suffice to say, if you came into the 2020 season hoping for a bit of drama, it looks like you won't be disappointed. Mercedes are on top form once again after an excellent race weekend. It's great to see them up on that podium once again.
Casper, listen, I don't know what happened out there. It wasn't my fault.
Well, whose fault was it then? Who was the idiot behind the wheel of your car, You're pathetic. You won't even admit when you made a mistake. How did they ever sign you?
Oh, Butler. Devon, I didn't see that.
What, like, out on the track today? You nearly took me out, mate.
Look, I don't know what happened. You cut in, I swerved. Next thing I knew, Casper was out.
Whoa. Mate, I was nothing to do with it. Whatever that was all on you. Don't be trying to pass the blame, because you haven't settled in yet.
Sorry, Aiden. Just bear with us one sec.
No problem.
I think that's really just a case of rookie driver, rookie mistake. These cars are a bit different than what Aiden's used to in F2.
You seem to find your feet quite quickly after you graduated from Formula 2. What advice would you give to Jackson in his first season?
Well, stay out of my way, mostly. And taking out your own teammate isn't something I would make a habit of.
Almost ready, Aiden. We're just checking audio levels.
Sure.
Seriously, Casper must be wondering what on earth Alfa Romeo were thinking.
That's great. Thanks, Devin.
Yeah.
Okay, Aiden. Let's talk about that incident with your teammate.
Brian.
Talk to me. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Listen, what happened out there today? I had it all under control and then...
Look, let's not go through all that now. We'll talk about it at the debrief.
Right, yeah.
I was actually talking about your little running with Casper and Butler over in the paddock.
Oh, wow. News travels fast.
The paddock talks, Aiden. Besides, I've got ears like a hawk. Listen, Butler's a clown. The man's ego is bigger than a... No, I've got nothing. Don't give it a second thought.
Thanks, Brian.
But Casper? Yes, he can get a little hot-headed, especially after a race. But you have got to work with him. That manoeuvre today...
Wasn't my fault, Brian.
It probably cost us points. I'll level with you. A lot of people on the team are disappointed, Aiden. And I'll be saying as much to Casper. Now, learn from it and move on. But you can't let it happen again. I'll see you at the debrief.